as he suffered, he demands our love. And because we suffer, he gives us his love. And he covers our
the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over the whole land. And Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
as a divine blasphemy. Another Kilgore Trout book there in the window was about a man who built a time machine so he could go back and see Jesus. It worked. And he saw Jesus when Jesus was only 12 years old. Jesus was learning the carpentry trade from his father. Two Roman soldiers came into the shop with a mechanical drawing of a device they wanted built by sunrise the next morning. It was a cross to be used in the execution of a rabble-rouser. Jesus and his father built it, and they were glad to have the work. And the rabble-rouser was executed on it.
We adore thee, O Christ, and we bless thee.
So it goes.
To the ground under the cross.
Adore.
Position
is where you put it, where you put it, where it is. Did you, for example, that large tank there, silver? How heavy the slow world is with everything put in place. Someday walks by a car beside him on the dropped rope, a leaf of yellow color is going to fall. It all drops into place. My face is heavy with the sigh. I can feel my eye breaking.
Gentlemen, my jests are of course in bad taste, indeed lacking in confidence. But, of course, that is because I do not respect myself. As if by design, I used to get into trouble in cases where I was not to blame in any way. At the same time, I was genuinely touched and penitent. I used to shed tears, and there was a sick feeling in my heart. Of course, a moment or so later, I'd realize it was all a lie, an affected lie. A revolting lie. All this penitence, this emotion, these vows of reform. Observe yourselves more carefully, gentlemen, and you will understand that it is so. I used to invent adventures for myself, and made up a life, as if to live, in some way.
From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over the whole land. And Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
why?
Jesus is stretched on the bed of his death. He offers his bruised limbs to his heavenly Father on behalf of sinful men. And to his fierce executioners, to be nailed to the shameful wood.
Billy, after all, had contemplated torture and hideous wounds at the beginning and the end of nearly every day of his childhood. Billy had an extremely gruesome crucifix hanging on the wall of his little bedroom in Ilium. A military surgeon would have admired the clinical fidelity of the artist's rendition of all Christ's wounds. The spear wound, the thorn wounds, the holes that were made by the iron spikes. Billy's Christ died horribly. He was pitiful.
Our kingdom is not as the kingdom of this world.
So it goes.
Our life on earth.
The priests settled down among their treasures and ate and drank with princes. And to the starving they said, suffer. Suffer as he suffered on the cross.
For
it is the will of God. And anyone believes what they hear over and over again. So the poor, instead of bread, may do with a picture of the bleeding, scourged, and nailed up Christ, and pray to the image of their helplessness.
Goats and tortures. When he stripped the final splinter from the icon, you could hear the lips of its creator speaking.
Thank you. passion, he himself begged mercy for his youth's transgressions.
To make an appointment for the sacrament of confession.
Concerning your letter in which you ask me to call a priest, and in which you ask me to wear the cross that you enclose, your own cross, your dog-bitten cross,
From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over the whole land. And Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
which had been hewn out of the rock.
Men of stone, had I your tongues or eyes, I'd use them so that heaven's vault should crack. She is gone forever. I know when one is dead and when one lives. She's dead as earth. Lend me a looking glass. If that her breath will mist or stain the stone, why then she lives. She lives. If it be so, it is a chance which does redeem all sorrows ever I have felt. The plague upon murderers, traitors all! I might have saved her. Now, she's gone forever. Cordelia. Cordelia. Stay a little. Come. No. No. No life. Why should a dog, a horse, a rat have life and now no breath at all? Never, never,
Never, never.
Blame everything on the government.
Billy's second letter started out like this. The most important thing I learned on Trofalmador is that when a person dies, he only appears to die. But he is very much alive in the past, so it is very silly to cry at his funeral. All moments, past, present, and future, always have existed, always will exist. When a Trofalmadorian sees a corpse, the only thing he thinks is that the dead person is in bad condition at that particular moment. But that the same person is doing just fine in plenty of other moments.
From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over the whole land. And Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
thank you.
enough to all. He would have no dealings with the crowd. It is no great trick to win the crowd. All that is needed is some talent, a certain dose of falsehood, and a little acquaintance with human passions.
The visitor from outer space made a serious study of Christianity to learn, if he could, why Christians found it so easy to be cruel. He concluded that at least part of the trouble was slipshod storytelling in the New Testament. He supposed that the intent of the Gospels, among other things, was to teach people to be merciful, even to the lowest of the low. But the Gospels actually taught this. Before you kill somebody, make absolutely sure he isn't well connected.
From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, there was darkness over the whole land. And Jesus cried out in a loud voice,
was I? How's your foot?
Swelling, visibly.
Ah, yes, the two thieves. Do you remember the story?
No.
It'll pass the time. Two thieves, crucified at the same time as our Savior. One.
Our what?
Our Savior. Two thieves. One is supposed to have been saved, and the other failed.
Save from what?
Hell.
I'm going.
And yet, how is it, this is not boring you, I hope, how is it that of the four evangelists, only one speaks of a thief being saved? The four of them were there, or thereabouts, and only one speaks of a thief being saved. Go return the ball, can't you, once in a way?
I really find this most extraordinarily interesting.
One out of four of the other three. Two don't mention any thieves at all, and the third says that both of them abused him.
Who?
What?
What's this all about? Abused who?
The Savior.
Why?
Because he wouldn't save them.
Well, what of it?
Then the two of them must have been damned.
And why not?
But one of the four says that one of the two was saved.
Well, The two of them don't agree, and that's all there is to it.
But all four were there, and only one speaks of a thief being saved. Why believe him rather than the others?
Well, who believes him?
Everybody! It's the only version they know.
People are bloody ignorant apes.
Jesus said to him,
pilgrim had stopped in the forest. He was leaning against a tree with his eyes closed. His head was tilted back and his nostrils were flaring. He was like a poet in the Parthenon. This is when Billy first came unstuck in time, and his attention began to swing grandly through the full arc of his life, passing into death, which was violet light. There wasn't anybody else there or anything. There was just violet light and a hum.
Known has bled to death under our knives. Who will wipe this blood off us?
What water is there for us to clean ourselves?
God is dead. God remains dead. And we have killed him.
How were we able to drink up the sea?
Who gave us the sponge to wipe away the entire horizon?
What did we do when we unchained this earth from its sun?
Are we not plunging through an infinite nothing?
Can we not feel the breath of empty space?
Hasn't it gotten colder?
Is it night and more night coming on all the while?
Do we smell
anything
yet
of God's
decomposition?
From the sixth hour.
Oh, how that death like famished dogs.
Until the ninth hour.
Not these howl, but a human howl.
There was darkness.
Not these howl, the cry of human.
Over the whole land.
He alone. He alone. Uttered the heavens.
And Jesus cried out in a loud voice, and gave up his spirit.
Had gone away on their yearly visit, and she swung on their little girl's swing.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Rejoice, O earth, in shining splendor, radiant in the brightness of your King. Christ has conquered glory, hails you. Darkness vanishes forever.
God said, "Let there be light." And there was light.
In him was life, and the life was the light of men.
This is our Passover feast, when Christ the true Lamb is slain, whose blood consecrates the homes of all believers.
And God said, "Let us create man in our image and likeness."
And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness grasped it not.
Oh, happy thought, unnecessary sin of our own, which came for us so great a redeemer.
And God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female.
It is the true light that enlightens everyone who comes into the world.
The Lord formed man out of the dust of the ground.
And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us.
Therefore, Heavenly Father, accept this Easter candle, a flame divided but undimmed, a pillar of fire that glows to the honor of God.
And God breathed into his nostrils the breath of life.
And we saw his glory, glory as of the only begotten of the Father.
Let it mingle with the lights of heaven, and continue bravely burning to dispel the darkness of this night.
And man became a living being.
Full of grace and of truth.
And reigns forever and ever.
here.